G'day, Ben here. So what is groov? Groov is an operator interface built from the ground up for your mobile device. We like to say that groov is mobile made simple. So I'm going to show you just how true that is. I'm going to build one app that works on my Android smartphone, this iPad, and Chrome on the Mac laptop. There are two ways to run groov: on this compact industrial appliance, or a software-only version that you install and run on your Windows-based computer. To boot up this groov box, all I had to do was plug in the network, plug in power, and hit the power button. That's about as easy as it gets to boot up this groov web server. Let's go log in. To do that, we need to go to a computer that's on the same network as the groov box. Next, start your browser. That's the only software you need to use groov. There's no downloads, no plugins, no PC admin rights, just a browser. That's all you need. Let's connect to this server. To do this, we type in HTTPS and the groov box address. Now, don't forget the S, because we're making a secure connection to the server. I've already created an admin account, so I'll just log in here and then click the gear icon in the upper right. There, I'm in build mode. The entire build environment is right here in the browser tab. In this quick demo, I'm going to create two gadgets, one attached to a control system directly in the room, and one from an OPC-UA server, which is connected to a PLC here in the building. So let's set up the tags for each of those systems now. First, for my Opto 22 control system, I select Add Opto 22 Controller, type in the address, and then select the controller tag file. Now, let's configure the OPC-UA tag server. Choose Add OPC-UA Server, put a name, and then the address, colon, and the port number. Click Add Server, and we're all set. Okay, it's time to start building our interface. Since I'm building a mobile app, let's switch straight into the mobile view. Add a new page, give it a name, click OK. Now, we simply drag and drop gadgets onto that page. I'll add a button so that I can turn the lights in the studio on and off. Drag it here, then go up to gadget properties and select the tag that the gadget will be connected to. I'm going to connect to the tag for the studio lights. Now, I'm going to drag a round gauge out to here, and then I'm going to live browse the OPC-UA tag tree and find the tag we want. The one I'm after is a float variable in our Allen Bradley PLC. There it is. Too easy. One tag on an Opto 22 controller and the other on a Compact Logic's PLC. There was no code, no programming, it's all just drag and drop. Now let's go test the button. Here's the screen we just built on an Android smartphone, an iPad, and Chrome on the Mac. And check this out. As I rotate my phone, everything scales to fit. That's how we can build one app that fits any screen size on any size device. When we said that groov was made for mobile, we really weren't kidding. All right, I'll just try this button out here on my smartphone. Yep, and let's turn the lights back on from the iPad. You little ripper. Now, it's your turn to do this on your mobile. Grab your phone and scan this QR code. Log in with the username trial and the password of Opto22. You can also download your free trial of groov from groov.com. Till next time, cheers, mate.